Judges, do you think it's unfair for government to want to impose a burden that forgetfulness and is unaccessible for people that has like mentally unstable, but they want to prove to you that people can like suppress their anger, like can for example control their anger and you get used to it, right? Because we say it's as hard or even harder for you to like meet with your aggressor every day and try to suppress their anger. We don't think that they can like play this scenario with such a basket scenario. But what kind of dominant narrative that they are going to impose to individuals, right? You think that it will be like status quo? It is a common belief and norm that you study at school, for example, that you need to forgive someone, that when you do forgive someone, you are a good person, that you go to pahala, for example, in heaven, right? But we don't think that we impose this kind of guilt tripping, that just because you don't want to forgive someone doesn't mean that you are a bad person. It just means that you need to take time to forgive someone, but you still have to strive to forgive this person, right? Because it's just like, for example, when you donate to someone, it's a virtue, but when you don't donate your money to people, it doesn't mean that you are a bad person just because you cannot, for example, donate your money to a poor people, right? So we say that they need to pay in this kind of context. First argument, first rebuttal. They say that it is not accessible for people that don't have like mentally stable mental health to forgive someone. Firstly, if we are talking about mentally unstable person, then yet you will most likely have the bad outcome that they are talking about. Like, Iki has already pointed out in the I didn't need to prove what he is exclusive to begin with, that these people will go to alcoholism just because they are feeling guilt trip, for example, right? But we think that exactly in all side of the house, you will try to ask for your help. If you do indeed, for example, getting guilt trip, that you want to get rid of this guilt trip feeling, right? That you want to go to psychiatrist, you want to talk to your friend. How can I help, for example, to forgive this ex, for example? That this is exactly the kind of thing that this mentally unstable person needs. That is how we can get forgiveness and exactly helping them to get this kind of mental health. But secondly, exactly for this kind of person, we think that forgiveness prepares them to do stupid things, right? That for, or like, it also helps them to like grow as a person. For example, if you don't forgive your ex, you will not be able to move on with another job, for example. You will never be able to, for example, get another relationship, right? You need to prove when you have this anger in their heart, they can move on with their life and their work as a person. We think that there is the burden that they need to defend. But second, they say that these people can familiarize with the anger and control their anger, right? Firstly, as I said in my opening, you need to explain why then that this familiarization of the anger is as easy as they time to see. Because as I said before, that you feel this anger any time and you cannot do anything about it. Most likely when you feel angry towards your bully, but if you punch your bully, then you will get even more repercussions, right? That you have to suppress your anger every day. In our sometimes you will have to forgive the bully, but this is better because you don't feel any kind of hatred, you don't feel like any kind of urge to punch the bully and get beaten up. Next, we say that giving ourselves the house exactly that forgiveness is something that's more accessible than their alternative. It is proof that their alternative is accessible. First argument, when the narrative brings goodness to people that wants to forgive someone, but it betters you as a human being, right? Because first, let's see, when do you need to forgive someone? We think that it is when someone hurts you. That when your boyfriend broke up with you, for example, when your friend broke your favorite cup, right? What does this mean? That this means that you already feel a lot of pain and anger and you feel hatred towards them. We think that this means that you are most likely going to be rational when you are forgiving someone. That because you do remember the pain and the hatred that you try one by one to reduce this kind of hatred, right? You say that this means that there are a lot of steps of forgiveness that you perhaps first that you question the reason behind the action. That second, you try to remember the good things about your friend. Perhaps she is actually a good friend that made you that was happy. I think that this means that you are more likely to be rational because you have to reduce the hatred that you feel so much that is so big that they consider in their self, right? But most of the time, there are a lot of things that you cannot, a lot of situations that you cannot do about anything, right? That is when someone took your phone and you don't see the perpetrator. That is when you got fired from your office and you cannot sue your office because exactly it's justified, right? That because that time when your bully you in the primary school, that you cannot, for example, reach the bully anymore. Yet in these cases, the best step you can do is letting go. Because in that side, you will be burdened. That is something you need to live with this hatred towards the bully. That this preference should go because you will always think of yourself as the victim of the bully. You always always see yourself as like a weak person that can be bullied by other person. I think that when you forget this bully, you can see yourself in a new life. You become a better person and a good person. The second argument, whether it will create a black denominator narrative is very important for our society to work and protect vulnerable individuals. Right? First, why does it give protection to vulnerable individuals? Because we need to see what is the basis of forgiveness. I think the most of the time, it is based on sympathy. Right? If you feel sorry to someone, it's when you feel sympathy to that person. That you can feel forgive, for example, a poor person for attacking a phone because they said you try to understand the reason. You sympathize with the reason. That you try to think that this condition of these poor people is so bad that they need to like feed the family. Right? That this means that they are more likely to like help and give a fair proposition towards people that doesn't have a bad intention. For example, there are two criminal cases. The first is that there is a black guy in the United States that becomes a thief because he is like economically disadvantaged. But on the other side, you have a rich corruptor that just wants to get richer. Right? Living outside of the house, even though you have the virtue, you are more likely to forgive this poor person because it's based on sympathy. Right? Why is this very expensive? That you want to reduce the sentences, for example. Like, that is why the justice system gives you lesser sentences when you can prove that you don't have a bad intention. We think that this is exclusive. Why? Because only when you have unlearned that your sympathy becomes something, that you want to reduce the sentences of these poor people, right? But in this case, even if you do have sympathy, you will not use this sympathy at all. Because even though you feel pitiful towards these poor people, you think that he deserves the maximum sentences. Because you do think that this person, even though they are only circumstantial, this person has done something bad and needs to be punished of it. You think that your anger is something because something that is very unjust, because a lot of people are just unlucky that they are born in a poor situation. You think that they need to prove whether not forgiving someone is very like basically just, because we say that in the vast majority of instances, you can't just can't help but to do mistakes because of the circumstances, because of who you are. Perhaps you are a psychopath, but exactly you are being, for example, being a victim on your childhood. Right? Don't say that, so we